Hey everybody, it's Jason Creel and you're watching the Lawn Care Life, and in today's video I'm talking about centipede grass, and I'm going to give you the tips you need to know to keep your centipede lawn looking great, or to help it get to be a great centipede lawn if it's not looking so great right now. We're going to talk about mowing, we're going to talk about fertilizer, and we're going to talk about the products I use to keep the weeds out of your centipede lawn. Today's video is sponsored by Graham Spray Equipment. I appreciate them sponsoring the channel, and if you want to use the spray rigs that I use on the back of my trucks to take care of my lawns, then go check out grahamse.com. The link is in the description. Let's get started right now. So if you look over this yard, it's a dormant Bermuda lawn, and we're in the winter time, so I don't have a nice, great centipede lawn to show you, but I can show you a picture of one. Coming up now is what a centipede yard is supposed to look like in the summertime. Now, I've seen some bad centipede yards in my day, and I've seen some good ones. And so I'm gonna talk to you about some of the mistakes that people make with their centipede grass, and some of the things I've learned. And I'm working with a guy that helps me and advises me and has taught me some things to help my centipede lawns that I take care of to look better. So let's talk about those things in this order. We're gonna first talk about the weed control side of things. Okay, we don't want weeds in our centipede lawn, but let me say this, centipede grass is more sensitive if you're dealing with warm season grasses. You know, your centipede and your St. Augustine are typically more sensitive than your Bermuda and your zoysia. I tell people, I say, listen, I can spray almost anything on a Bermuda lawn. I mean, don't take that literally, but you know, it's a little hardier, and it's hard to damage a Bermuda lawn. But with your centipede lawns, you've got to be careful, because you can actually cause some serious damage to the lawn by trying to keep the weeds out that makes them look even worse. So I tell people, I say, listen, you may have to live with a little bit of weeds, a little bit of weed pressure in the springtime, especially until the grass gets fully green. So I'm in Alabama. Here's what we do. In my round one, or the first treatment of the year, which is typically January, February timeframe, I go in with some atrazine, which is an inexpensive product. And just by the way, I'm gonna put some links to these products in the description below. But go in with atrazine, and at a low rate, which can help with the broadleaf weeds, or let's say you got some clover, or you got stuff like that. The atrazine can help get rid of those weeds. But also going to put a low rate of pre-emergent in there. Now, my centipede yards typically don't get a lot of crabgrass, but sometimes they do. And hopefully that pre-emergent, again at a low rate, I'm using prodiamine. Let me show it to you. You know, this is the product I use, and this is a Resolute 65WG, and you can see their active ingredients, prodiamine. I'm using this at like 0.55 pounds per acre on the centipede lawns. So, you know, hopefully if there was any, especially if you had one that had some thin grass, or maybe you can see some crabgrass remains from the previous year and you know it had a little bit of a crabgrass issue, then this is gonna help with that. So it's atrazine and the prodiamine. Then on the second application of the year is in that springtime when you're getting on into March and maybe into April, and this is where you wanna be careful, because and I've done this before, but a lot of the labels you'll read about your herbicides will say don't spray during transition. And this is especially something to be cautious of when you're dealing with centipede grass. So if you were to go in there and spray a herbicide on your centipede grass while it's transitioning out of dormancy, let's say it's 50% green, you could probably use atrazine in that situation without causing much damage. But if you're going there and use other herbicides on your centipede lawn during that spring transition, you can seriously delay the green up. I mean, you know, a month, 2 months later than an untreated part would turn green. And one of the things you want to be careful with too is centipede, and just maybe informing your customers or being aware of your own lawn, is that sometimes it can turn green quicker than other grass types in the springtime. And then if you get a hard freeze late, it can stun it then. So it's not always, you know, what you sprayed on the yard. It may just be the weather that's causing damage. But as far as what you spray, you know, like I said, use the atrazine early in the year, and then in that springtime we put some kind of supplemental things in there, maybe some humic acid and some other products that we have that we're using to help those lawns recover from winter, to be able to give them a little bit of nitrogen to help them start to green up. But we wait at that point. I try to communicate this with the customers that, hey, we're gonna wait until that lawn is green before we put much herbicide on the lawn. So, you know, it may be on into to late April or even May when it's fully green. And then I'm saying, okay, now you got weeds. Now, you might say, well, what if my yard has tons of weeds in the spring? Well, you can spray it. Like I say, with atrazine, it's probably gonna be your safest bet without causing damage. But just know that if you use other herbicides, that you may seriously delay the green up. So, but hopefully, and we'll talk about this in a minute, but if you use a pre-emergent in the fall, you're gonna prevent a lot of those weeds to where there's not a lot of weeds in the yard to start with. All right, so once the weather gets warm, then you can come in and take out any weeds. Like, for instance, I had a situation, let me say this, if the yard is fully dormant, that's also a good time to go after the weeds. Or if it's fully green, it's just during that transition where it's part green, part brown, you don't want to go and spray it at that time. All right, so once it turns fully green, or even in a situation where it's maybe mostly dormant, like I had a centipede yard the other day and it was just loaded with field matter, and it's a tough weed, and atrazine is not going to be very effective against it. And so what I did was put in a change up at a really low rate, like 10 ounces per acre, and a really low rate of metsulfuron, which is an example of that. You mix those two together, and you can use that later on too when it turns green. But I did it, you know, in February while it was still dormant to get rid of that field matter. Now, in cold weather, it's going to be slow to die. But anyway, that's the combination I use. Now, you're going to fertilize it in the summertime and spot treat your weeds. That change up's a great product to spot treat stuff that gets in your centipede lawn, like Lespediza. You might have some spurge, chamber bitter, things like that, and change up works great on those, Virginia buttonweed. As far as the fertilizer goes, well let me continue on with the weed control. As you move into the fall, put out either the prodiamine, or this year I actually went and was using a low rate of spectacle flow. I was using it like 4 ounces per acre, and that made a significant difference in what my yards looked like this spring. So again, if you put that pre-emergent out in the fall, hopefully you're not gonna have a lot of weeds to deal with the following spring. And then with that pre-emergent in the fall, I'm also putting simazine in there. So as far as fertilizers go, I use 18-1-9 blend from Harrell's. And the key here is you don't wanna use more than 2 pounds of nitrogen per calendar year. So, you know, I'm using like 0.9 pounds of nitrogen the first application, which is typically done around May, and then come back 2 months later and use another 0.9 pounds of nitrogen, or 0.85 pounds of nitrogen. So, you know, it comes out to like a bag for every 9,000 square feet, 9 or 10,000 square feet. I have to do the math to figure that out exactly. But that's what I'm doing. Again, don't overload your centipede grass with nitrogen. It's not going to probably have that deep, dark green color that you could get with a Bermuda lawn or even a zoysia lawn if you put more nitrogen. You don't want to do that on your centipede lawns. Now in the winter time, we put out lime on our centipede lawns. You know, sometimes centipedes can tolerate a little bit lower pH, but we add lime in our program, and you can do a soil test you want. In our area, almost all the lawns are acidic. We just have very acidic soil, so the lime is built into the program. Now what about mowing the lawns? Now I've seen people that want to mow their centipede lawn every 2 weeks, and they've got it 4 inches tall, and they mow it down to 3.5 inches tall, and it will tolerate that, but that's not ideal, and honestly it's going to lead to more weed pressure. So typically the centipede yards that I've seen that look the best, and this includes some that I don't think the people do any weed control at all on, is that they mow it short. I know one particular yard I've got in my mind is a guy, and he's out there mowing his yard probably weekly at 1 inch tall, and he's just mowing, mowing, mowing. I don't think he has any kind of weed control program going at all, and it looks pretty good because it's just really nicely mowed and done frequently, and it creates a nice thick centipede grass that helps choke out the weeds on its own. And if there are weeds, you're mowing them every week and they don't like that, so it puts a lot of mowing pressure on the weeds. Now, you might not mow your yard every week, but I would encourage you when it's growing fast to mow it as, you know, weekly if you can, or as often as you can, and to mow it lower. Like I said, it's not ideal to let it get 3.5-4 inches tall and mow it back down to 2 inches. The rule of thumb obviously is to not mow more than a third of the grass blade off at a time, but But typically keeping it low, you know, an inch to 2 inches, but so, you know, I probably mow mine an inch and a half. I think that's the lowest my mower setting will go. But when I've had centipede lawns, that's what I've tried to do. Mow it frequently and keep it at an inch and a half. So to sum it up, your applications, you can use a little pre-emergent in the spring, use a little bit of pre-emergent in the fall. You want to do it, you know, I say spring, you want to really do it before those spring weeds start germinating in my area. It's January, February time frame. In the fall, we're putting out sometimes September, October time frame. And then you want to be careful during your transition periods. The change-up metsulfuron combo at a really low rate is good for your weeds, whether it's fully dormant or after it turns green. Also, if you get a lot of spring weeds and it's during transition, I encourage you not to spray it unless you maybe use some atrazine, but you can start mowing it then and keep it mowed low at an inch to 2 inches, somewhere around that inch and a half range, and mow it frequently will help you have a nicer centipede lawn. Don't overdo it. Don't go crazy on your fertilizer. Less than 2 pounds of nitrogen per calendar year. If this stuff makes sense to you, I'm glad. If it doesn't make sense, I'm sorry about that. There are some links in the description to the products I've mentioned. You'll be able to see some of the weeds that showed up on the video as well. And we are offering training if you're in the weed control and fertilization business, or maybe you're in the mowing business, you want to add weed control and fertilization. We've got courses over at lawncarelife.com, even courses where we teach you how to get in this business and their son. They even have a live 8-week interactive program that we are starting this March, and hopefully it will continue to do in the future. So check those out, lawncarelife.com. Appreciate you watching the video. I'm Jason Creel. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so, and we'll talk to you guys later. Bye.